New at 6, a major archaeological and biblical discovery in Israel is drawing attention from around the world. It is less than 2 inches long and 1 inch wide, and it has a mid-state connection. Seth Kaplan explains.
This tiny tablet is a big deal.
There's reverberations from that earthquake.
A metaphorical earthquake, to be clear, one shaking the archaeological and biblical studies world for people like Scott Stripling, director of excavations for Associates for Biblical Research. It started with artifacts excavated decades ago in a place called Mount Ebal, otherwise known as the Mountain of the Curse. Joshua is believed to have built an altar there.
We, with our new technology, went back through his discard pile, and in that pile, we recovered a small 2x2 centimeter lead curse tablet, a lead tablet that had very, very archaic Hebrew writing on it.
You went through Joshua's garbage.
Well, yes, we as archaeologists love garbage.
Garbage, Stripling says, cleans up two big questions.
Number one, it proves that the text was in existence very early in what we would call the late Bronze Two periods.
About 1400 to 1200 BC.
So when people have argued that Moses could not have written the Pentateuch because there was no alphabetic script with which to do that, we now know that that's just simply not accurate.
The language on the tablet?
It is a morphing of Egyptian hieroglyphs into phonic representations for the very first time.
Archaic Hebrew, he says. Number two, on a tablet that actually contains a curse, people cursing themselves but giving themselves a chance to repent.
This is the oldest example we have and the only example we have from the land of Israel itself, from this early time period, of the name Yahweh.
Discovered by an organization based in Akron, Lancaster County, founded back in the 1960s by a man named David Livingston.
David had roots there, and that's, you know, where it sort of naturally ended up. So all of our staff is in that area. I'm the exception. I'm down here in Texas in the other promised land.
Seth Kaplan, ABC 27 News.